This is Huge Movie Fanatics, and we are to do a strange review.
Yeah, this is. You never know that Nate, that I'm Nate, that I saw that I would see this movie.
Like I'm a fan of sort of A, romances and B, comedies. Although I'd hesitate to call this a comedy, really.
No,
but, I mean it kind of is. So like, if I had it my way, we'd do a lot more of those. But
oh well, you can. Sorry, oh, yeah. You can
no, no,
do
no, no.
solo.
No, 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 no.
I mean,
no. Yeah,
the feelings are coming out.
No, no, no. I don't mind. Oh, like I could do solo ones, but I like doing like.
Well,
the,
right.
The bouncing
yeah, unfortunately,
off.
I don't. See,
yeah. So yeah. Like, I mean, in a perfect world.
In a perfect world, we'd yeah.
both have.
Yeah.
Seen every movie around. So we're to do Nick and Nora's Infinite Playlist. Which is a great title, by the way. I saw this movie and was really excited to see this movie because I had just come off of Juno, and I was a big fan of Juno. This had Michael Cera. Michael Cera, who was in Juno, is one of my favorite actors of at the time. He was really sort of like budding, and he came from one of the like easily the five best TV shows ever made, which was Arrested Development. This is the funniest show that has ever been on television. It lasted 3 years. It dominated the Emmys all 3 years that it was on TV. Nobody watched the show at all. And so it was just, it's one of those things where it's like, fucking public, don't you understand? This is brilliant! Little side fact, Arrested Development got renewed for a fourth season and a feature film coming out this next year, this coming year. 2013. So there you have it. Go Netflix. Netflix brought it back for 10 episode season and a movie which is going to be released theatrically. So there you go. So anyway, I was excited to see this movie because I liked him, and she, what's her name? Oh my god.
Kat Dennings.
She had just come out of The 40-Year-Old Virgin, which I'd seen a couple of years prior, and I really liked her.
Don't
in
we see
that.
Her naked?
No. So
anyway,
like both of these actors.
Nora's Infinite Planets.
I like both of these actors, so I was excited to see the movie, and I saw it, and it was fine. Like, I guess I have no problems. There were a couple lines that sort of stuck with me, and I like the performances. He's kind of a douchebag throughout most of the movie, a little bit, which I don't like because he's such a likable, good character.
When you say he's a douchebag, what do you mean?
Like, he's just with this girl because the girl that he really wants is taken, so he's just sort of like settling and sort of. And he kind of plays the douchebag angle. Like, the moment she shows interest in him, he's like, well, F. Kat Dennings, I'm going to go back to the other girl, Alexa Denza.
Oh, which I must comment on. I do not buy the fact that a girl that looked like that, like his ex-girlfriend or whatever, would even be with a guy like
that. I do, because there's
well,
something.
Well, hopefully. Good luck. Then I got a chance.
There's something charming about the. He has a puppy dog quality to him.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
I think that's good, what yeah. That's what it is.
Yeah.
Like, my problem was that he was kind of a douchebag in this, and I'd only seen him in roles where he's, like, such the good guy, and you're really rooting for him. So it was really hard to root for him, which you were ultimately supposed to do in the movie. But I really liked her. Kat Dennings was really good, and she's. I'm glad that her career is sort of blossoming. She has a TV show out now called Two Broke Girls, which is kind of funny. And she was just in Thor. I think she's going to be in the Thor sequel, so that's kind of cool. I guess I'm going to give the movie. I'll give it 2.5. It was cute and harmless, but, like, I don't know. I don't think I could see it again.
Yeah, I actually picked the movie up half price for $3, and you know, what the hell? I've actually seen it twice, and actually, there's only one reason why, or actually two reasons why I saw this movie, and actually, because I used to work at a video store, and I'd walk by the box all the time, and I'd be like, see a low cut top, and I'd turn it over, and like, wow, a low cut top and stuff. And so Kat Dennings is the only reason I had any interest in. So I saw a half price books. I'm like, $3, okay, you know. And I put it in, and I was like, wow, this is really kind of cool. I mean, it's nothing. It's not epic by any stretch of the imagination. It's nothing. I'm gonna go 3 stars because it's just such a great depiction. I think it's just one night.
Yeah, just one night.
One night, and it's such a great depiction of, you know, just being young and doing whatever. And I think it's very. It's completely and totally like inoffensive, except for the, again, I think the drunk girlfriend wasn't as bad as I thought the guy in Tintin was, except for the one scene that I completely skipped the second time I watched it, was when she was in the bathroom and she like puked in the toilet and then dropped her gum in the puke. I'm like, all right, you know, the puke looked pretty nasty in the toilet, and she's like picks a gum out of the
forgot
puke
about that scene,
and
yeah.
Yeah, I skipped it the second time and shall ever from this henceforth from this moment on. And I'm gonna go 3 stars. I thought, I mean, you're right, I mean, I think that's the first movie I've ever seen. No, well, I did see Juno, but you know, I think the guy, whatever his name is, was kind of a bag of dudes. And you know, or whatever, and it you know, and I just thought it was a nice, modest little thing. And I actually liked how it looked, and you could see, even on DVD, you could kind of see the film grain, and I really liked how it looked. And it was just a really cool, like, this is just a rom-com of youth and stuff.
Yeah.
And it one, makes me, you know, miss being young, and two, glad I'm not young anymore, kind of a thing. Because, you know, it's like, you know, those days are fine, but at the same time, you know, there's a time to move on.
I think the reason that it kind of works a little bit is because of it's a little more serious. It's like not a goofy comedy.
That's
more like a realistic comedy where you just sort of have funny people. And that's what makes it work. But like the story itself is a serious story.
Yeah, and I love the very end and the aspect of the whole thing that they're waiting for that stupid concert or whatever, Where's Fluffy, and the fact that I think they left it or something to go and do whatever, presumably do whatever. And I thought it was such a great, I think it's the end, and I thought it was such a great line when she gets like on the escalator, and the guy does, he's going down, and she's like, are you sad we missed it? And he's like, we didn't miss it, this is it.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that cool?
Yeah,
that is pretty cool. And I gotta say, I'm usually not a rom-com, you know, kind of a guy, but I thought that was a great little thing. This is it.
Yeah.
You know, this is gonna be it. I thought 3 stars.
I'd give it 3 stars, and I did at the time, if only that he wasn't such like a
douchebag
through most of the movie. Like, it's really hard to root for somebody who's kind of just using this person to get back with the person he really wants to be, who's clearly a twit to begin with.
A twit, yeah.
So, I mean, it's hard to find sympathy for that character. So that's why I bumped the star rating down a little bit. But, like, it's a competently, very competently made movie. It's very well acted. And I do give 2.5 at the end of the day.
Sounds great. There's Nick and Nora's alternate playlist, which, as I say the title, I wouldn't imagine, like I say, us reviewing, or me, having seen it, so that's why I laughed. But that's our review of that, and catch you guys later.